Well, it's really important because when sea ice covers the ocean surface, it provides a kind of blanket for heat that the ocean heat can't be transferred to the atmosphere. So there's a big difference in the way in which the atmospheric circulation happens, and there's a big difference in the ocean circulation. Everything is different if you have ice sitting on the surface. As the ice retreats, you get an acceleration of global warming because you're replacing a white surface which reflects most of the radiation falling on it by a dark surface which absorbs most of the radiation. So that's called the albedo, and that produces the loss of ice will create a big albedo change which will increase the rate of warming of the planet. So there's the warming effect. And then also the retreat of the ice means that the ocean warms up, and that has an effect on the ocean bed and allows nasty things from under the ocean bed to be released, especially methane, which at the moment is trapped underneath the sediments because the sediments are frozen. But as the sediments thaw out because of the ocean warming, the methane is released, and that again will accelerate global warming. So everything that's happening as a result of the retreat of the sea ice tends to accelerate global warming. And then a third effect is that the fact that with open water in the Arctic in the summer, you get warmer winds, and those warmer winds move over Greenland and cause an accelerated rate of melt of the Greenland ice cap, and that increases the rate of global sea level rise.